So what we're going to do now is I'm going to set a timer for 60 minutes. You're free to work by yourself or in teams. You may not be able to use it on your iPad, so you guys will probably have to join up with other people and you can help them. Yeah. And if you need a buddy, just raise your hand or just find somebody. I like to encourage people to sit with people they don't know to kind of use it as a networking opportunity as well. It's too easy to sit with people you know. Ask us questions along the way. There's also the rest of the Information Lab team here to help. And then if you want, post your results on Twitter using the hashtag MakeOverMonday if you're on Twitter. If not, don't worry about it. Feel free to post it up on Tableau Public. And if you don't finish, don't worry about it. It's okay. Incomplete results are fine. We're actually going to, the data set we're going to use this week is actually from last week, because we used the one for this week, which was based on Formula E driving results, and it's a pretty hard data set to work with, so we thought we'd give you something a bit easier that's a bit more fun, easier to understand as well. So for this week, or for today, you guys are going to look at the same data set that we used for Makeover Monday Live at the Tableau Conference in Las Vegas last week. And this is adult obesity in America, state by state and year by year. So it's a pretty simple data set. You have a column for years, you have a column for the state, and you have a column for the obesity rates. And your job is to, this is the original visualization. So you see they have a simple map here. And in this particular map, they have little filters down here at the bottom you can click on to drill down into a specific region. They have it's not showing on here, but there's a slider for the years as well, where you can, you know, kind of go through the years and see the map change. And it's just color-coded by the obesity rate. And then on the right-hand side, these are the trends for the states over the years. I think ours only goes back to 2010 or 2012, something like that. That's as far back as I could get the data. So, but you kind of get the idea on this is the original visualization, so just to maybe give you an idea on the starting place. But the idea is to create something that you're interested in, explore the data, and build whatever you can, and then at the end, we'll ask some of you to come up and present. And don't be afraid, we're not gonna criticize you in front of other people. We might have to leave, but that's okay. No. And then we'll show what we did, and then we'll be all done. Any questions? I guess you need the data, right? That would be helpful. So if you go to makeovermonday.codecuk/data.
Yeah. And then go to week 41, because week 42 is the Formula E data, which is a little bit trickier to work with.
So if you go up here to the Makeover Monday page and you click on this data sets tab at the top, and then under 2017, just click on the week sort twice and then go down to week 41. And if you already, if you're on Tableau 10.4, you can just click on this TWBX link and then download the workbook and reopen it, and you're all set. Otherwise, just use the Excel file. Any questions?
Also, if you want to work at a table, there's obviously tables on the side.
Oh, it might be easier.
Take your chair, maybe sit over there if that's more comfortable. Up to you.
Any questions? If you need help getting the data, we also have a flash drive if your computer is locked down for some reason. So just let us know. Understand? Yes?
Cool.
Should we stop talking?
Yeah.
Yes?
All right. Turn on some music.
Yeah. All right.
Hi.
No, pasa. Erika, solo pasa, solo pende. Ok. Erika, ci vuoi mettere in mezzo?
Sì, adesso ci organizziamo, solo magari riuscire ad avere la connessione.
Sì, sta facendo i dati.
Ah, sì, però magari era buono anche avere la connessione, magari volevamo guardare qualcosa
di green. Ah, hai ragione. Vediamo un po'.
Should I delete these other things?
Oh, that's right.
Okay, does anybody need the data on a flash drive? Turn it around so they can see the...
Yes, good idea.
Didn't feel like it's going in front. All right, you guys ready? Everybody ready? So since there's only six groups, we figured everybody could present. Sound good? So do you want to go back to front or front to back? It's your choice. You want to go first or last? You can go first. Come on up.
Well, we have so little time. I'm not really enthusiastic about our dashboards.
Come on, Eddie. You got to come up anyway. Come on.
I don't know. Maybe one of them would like to present.
No,
I'm doing something I don't want to do. Okay?
Andy is famous for making people do exactly that.
No, the thing is, we had little time. We didn't think the data through. When we talked about the product, we didn't know much about it.
So like we said at the beginning, it's not necessarily about being done.
I'm a Tableau customer. I've been a Tableau customer for a long time now, like at least 5 years. I've been a consultant before, and now I was hired by a customer a year ago, and I work full-time on Tableau. So what we did here, first of all, we spent a lot of time figuring out the data source and all, because it wasn't at all easy to understand how it worked. And then what we did was try to analyze all the dimensions we had and see if we could figure out if there were some of the dimensions that were particularly significant. We actually didn't find anything significant because it seems that the data was more or less the same if we change dimension. Anyway, this is a time series. We made a time series about the average percentage of obesity. And then here we did a year over year. The first year we had on the data source and the last year on the data source. So 2011 and 2015.
So kind of the start and the end of the period.
The start and the end of the period to see if we had a huge delta somewhere. And we split it. So that we could see if there was some significance somewhere. Actually, we didn't. I mean, it seems like they evolved in the same way. There wasn't a category that evolved in a different way.
Everybody's getting fatter.
Yeah. Everybody's getting fatter, no matter the age, the income, the education.
Yeah.
So
sad.
That's what I was saying. I mean, we didn't notice anything particular. Okay. And then here, we just wanted to ask to exercise and do what you did with the bikini. So we put males and females, but here again, they seem pretty
consistent.
Similar.
Yeah.
And then what we did was this. This is a time series, so we can filter the year here.
Okay,
and here we just played with the map because Alaska was so far away, and if we put Alaska here, the map was really tiny. Mm-hmm. So we just zoomed in. We doubled the map so that we had the same color, because if you just filter, you would have a different color for Alaska, and so you wouldn't have the same color legend for all.
Good.
So we just duplicated it and then just zoomed in.
Zoomed in from here
and here. And then we just filtered. We did an action filter. But this time, just from this map to these two, and from this map to these two, because we didn't want this to disappear. We didn't want America to disappear when you clicked on Alaska.
Right.
And here we just put age and income, because they were the first two graphs we did, and we didn't have time to do something else.
So what about the labeling on your map there? It looks like you did something interesting there.
We put the maximum and minimum.
Okay.
And we did that with the obesity rate
as the
maximum.
Good.
And on the table.
Okay.
Little time again. Usually we do more.
It's okay.
Sophisticated stuff. So
it's hard to do in an hour.
It's hard to do it in an hour, and we also talked about the product.
Okay.
All, so.
Cool. All right. Good job. Well done. You guys want to go next?
No,
I saw you doing all the work.
No, he has done most of the work.
It's not for 2 weeks.
No. It is.
It's not going to stick. Just put it up here. Resolution.
Tableau. I'm not a customer, not a Tableau consultant, so this is a need with the help of Emanuele. So we just Some time in understanding the data as the first group made, because data was just a bit crazy. So you had the category and subcategory that was strange to understand and to use. So he, I just started going with the map and creating a map with the United States, and we just filtered in order to avoid showing Alaska and some other islands. So this is just the percentage of the obesity, obese people in each country. Okay, so. And then I just was helped by Emanuele in order to create a little parameter over there. If I use this parameter, I can change the category, as you see here. So I can choose age or education or gender, income or total. So if I change, for example, to education, then I can see that the lower frames, the lower charts, will change in values. Okay, that was a tip that he made because I did not know how to do it. And what can we see in these charts? So we can see actually, this is the percentage of obesity for the parameter value, right?
Yeah.
And below we can see, let's go down, we can see, oh yes, the trend over the years. So we have here the years and the trend for each value of the parameter.
So what's the lollipop showing? What's the lollipop showing?
The lollipop, the sample size.
Sample size, okay. I was going to say, because it doesn't match the obesity rate.
No,
okay.
The sample size.
Okay.
Okay, and in the last chart we have the yes, the sample size. So how many people were interviewed for the obesity information, and the average percentage of obesity. And so we can see here that let me check here. So it. Even if we have many more people interviewed for the college graduate, then we have less percentage of obese people than, for example, the other, the red one, which is the less than high school.
Yeah.
Right. So it does not depend on the
sample size.
On the sample size. Okay. So it's not for the fact that we have interviewed more people than.
Sure.
We have higher
yeah.
values.
So you're disproving the relationship there then? Yeah.
Yeah, there is no relationship.
You're proving there's no relationship between
how many people we have seen and
cool.
the percentage.
Good.
Okay. So this he has made most of it. So
it's okay.
Yes,
all
I
right.
have tried to understand everything he has done.
Good.
So that's it.
Well
okay.
done.
Yeah.
Yes.
Who's that? You guys want to go next? Did he put his laptop away? Everybody in the back is still working too, so they're getting extra minutes. They're cheating.
That's not fair.
Look at them, they're not even listening. They're just cheating.
You're cheating.
That's not. Bonus points for getting it up on Tableau Public. All right.
Okay.
This is our first dashboard in Tableau. We have tried to change the shape the shape icon and for the history of data. In the top left, we have the our first map with the data of the percentage of obesity.
Mm-hmm.
In the right, we have all category and the subcategory and the evolution of data on for by year. And in the bottom, we have the same data, but by age and gender. Now,
like the icons,
I can't show in one page, but if I move the ear, you can see the movement of the icon.
The page is only available on desktop.
Yes.
Oh, that's neat.
Oh, yeah. That's it.
Good job, well done.
On the left side.
Huge laptop.
And one.
Well, actually, we wanted to do something fancy, and instead of pointing out some insights and finding patterns inside of the data, we decided to use the small multiple idea in order to have rows and columns
mm-hmm.
organized by some formulas. And the only detail you will see in this dashboard is that the value of the main icon got bigger according to the average value of the obesity index, and we added some more interactivity or something connected to the data exploration, because you can select even if it's not well displayed, but we were running out of time and we talk a lot. You can select which main category you want
the summary at the top as well.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, the difference in the bottom of the dashboard is not that big from a category to another, but you can see there are slightly differences.
Mm-hmm.
Well, when you select a category, then you can choose between the subcategory according to the category you selected, and you can see the bigger is and the darker is the circle marker. The highest is the value of the obesity. So you can also filter by selecting a single year, or you can multiple filter, maybe using the combination of category,
yeah.
subcategory,
and the year,
or simply you can select the only combination you want. Well, I think I got the single click value, but in the future, maybe when this go enterprise version, you will select. It's already an enterprise version, okay?
Yeah.
So you can select multiple filters,
yeah.
and
yeah.
you can see how the single states. Change according to the filter you select, and you can get the overall average index for the selected state according to the filters with the over on the icon, and that's basically what we did.
Nice, very creative.
Yeah.
You guys next? Is he still working? She's trying to hide in the back, too.
More
your
time
back,
than us.
So.
That's not fair.
We expect the stellar results.
You got an extra 10 minutes because you're sitting there working.
Such a beautiful moment past me,
right? Last and most of the least, in this case. Okay. We are beginners with Tableau, so do not expect so much. We have basically three views. On the right, the map as the others, with the split for west side and east side, and the percentage.
we try to make the evolution through the years. So you can see.
Oh, you did east versus west, okay.
Yes,
yeah.
Exactly. On the left side, the growth for from 2011 to the 2015, so the basis is 2011. And we noticed that there are two states which are the worst. And here we can select the category, so we can go through the, of course, the subcategories, gender. And
so that's the change versus 2011, right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. And last year we had the trend. This is just the trend for from the 2011 to the 2015
right.
On the bottom, basically.
Very good. Good job.
Did you go as well?
No, you go next week. Okay.
Is there anybody else that I've missed? That has to put their laptop away?
Filippo.
Filippo? He can't do it in an hour. Filippo can't do it in an hour.
Doesn't have Photoshop again.
Oh boy.
I'm so sorry.
No, we've got one here, don't worry. Nice try though. She thought she was gonna get out of it.
All the United States, so we can see the loss of obesity is in one state, Puerto Rico, and go to Mississippi, that is the state with the most. The
so it's a ranking, basically,
yeah,
right?
Only
yeah.
The ranking,
yeah.
Because I think it was interesting to see in all the United States in this way, okay?
Mm-hmm.
And. Nothing. This one that is not so special. So we have one category, and we can see the obesity near not through the years.
Mm.
So in Alabama, from the years, we can saw the obesity. In this is only the category. Okay, I make a mistake of the.
That's just the total.
Graduation.
Yeah.
Okay. And this is the dragon.
Good, you build a lot of stuff in,
yeah.
In an hour. Good job, well done. Anybody left? Did you put your laptop away? I saw you with a laptop. He had his laptop out.
Of course, I have a on my dog.
Oh, interesting. Interesting. Anybody else not believe that?
Yeah.
Okay, so we'll kind of wrap up here. Let me show you what Eva did first. Do you need just the picture of your...
Yeah, but how much time did you have?
This one I actually had to do on the plane because I was on my way to Vegas. So this was less than an hour. Definitely. While Andy brings this up, what I wanted to say also is it doesn't have to be in English. I mean, yes, the biggest audience is if you put something up in English, but if you're more comfortable doing a viz in your own language, please, you know, don't feel you have to do something that we can understand. Because there will be still people who understand and use that. So, okay, so what I did was, because there was quite a bit of detail with all the different states across all the years and the categories, I tried to focus it on something else. Or like a subset, so I just focus on the south. I went to Wikipedia to look up what the different regions are, just so that I, because there's the south, there's like an, you know, official number of states that fit into that. So I selected those and just looked at how they are comparing to the U.S. average rate. So the average across the whole country is my reference line, and then all the states that are above that average are in purple, and the ones that are below. In grey,
And on the right-hand side is just a slope chart that shows between 2011 and 2015 how they've progressed. So there's two states.
Well, regressed.
Well, regressed, most of them. So Florida and D.C. are the only ones that are below the average. And then I think D.C. is the only one that actually went down rather than going up.
I was actually inspired by a guy named Neil, Michael Mixon, who had done a map similar to this, where it's kind of every state is given kind of the same equal sizing. He did it with a different data set, but I wanted to try. I was using it as a way to practice, like we talked about earlier. You're inspired by things that other people do. So I started by, and I also liked in the original the filtering by the region. So I included little tiles at the top that you can click on to filter by the region. And then I used the same color scheme that was in the original. And when you hover over a color, it'll just highlight those year. So within each state, you can see each bar represents a year. So you can see the trends within each state. And if you click on, for example, the West, it'll then zoom in on the West. And the Midwest, and so on and so forth. So that was pretty fun to create. And this is just looking at the overall percentage. So you can see it looks like the South is the worst for obesity. And this is using that total metric that you see in there. And then the title and the subtitle I actually took from the article itself. So there was some really good detail in the article, and that's kind of what I used as the basis for my analysis. So I took the sentences they had and turned it into an analytical story. And then, like all of you guys, I also looked at the different breakdowns. So for education, I focused on the least educated versus the most educated. So, and this made it really clear. I was really surprised when I looked at it this way. You can see basically there appears to be a large correlation between education and obesity. So maybe that's access to food or money you have to spend on food. Yet, if you have less money, you probably buy cheaper foods that aren't as high quality and things like that. So this was particularly startling to me. So once I did it for education, I was like, well, I should look at some of the other demographics and see if there's the same sort of pattern. So I looked at income, and not surprising, it's basically the same as the education. So the people that make the least amount of money are also have the highest obesity rates, and people that make the most money have the lowest obesity rates. And again, I did the same kind of highlighting and filtering, so it's really startling when you look at, the morbidly obese people, the ones that are over 35, that have over 35% of the population is obese. It's really quite sad, actually. And then I looked at it by gender, and you don't see quite as stark of a difference, so they're relatively the same for gender. For females, in particular, the South is bad, and other than that, it looks like it's pretty much the same across the different measures. The really sad thing is that nobody falls into these first two categories, so everybody's, most states, the least is D.C. and Colorado and Hawaii. So, but this is a way for me to also get all of the states into a single list. Yeah. So once I created one of these, it was really easy to just duplicate it and just swap out the dimension because it's just filtering, and that was really easy. So, that's it. Okay. I think the last thing we need to do before you guys go is to get a group photo, if you don't mind. So we can add you guys to our collection. We can just do it over here in the corner. And thank you very much for coming.